It's a couple Jordan 1 retros and they gotta be in your collection. You just collect them, you never go stepping. I can respect it, but that ain't for me. I gotta lace up these black cement threes and throw a little fit together. Get on the go, out, place a bid, and hopefully I can just hit forever. I'm from the bottom, a little one arrive, but it's part of our culture, you gotta be proud. Where I'm flying with the Air Forces, put that shit on to the day that I die. Nikes over Adidas.
What's going on, YouTube? It's your boy the Retro Wiz Kid, the Shoeologist, and y'all rocking with your boy in the Sneaker Dungeon, y'all. Hope everyone's having a great day. You guys see by the thumbnail and title, we are doing one of my favorite videos. I love doing these on the channel, and that is that comparison. We have the 2014 Carmines right here. We have the 2021 Carmines right here. Shout out to the bro, the Vintage, for letting us get this pair for this video. If you guys are new to the channel, before we get all the way into this video, make sure you guys hit that subscribe button and ring that notification bell. Join your boy, the Retro Wiz Kid, and the Sneaker Dungeon family. We are on the grind of 20,000 subscribers this year, y'all. I appreciate all the continuous love and support, and it does not go unnoticed. Let's try to get this video up to 800 likes, y'all. I'm trying to get all the videos to 100 likes, y'all. Y'all make sure that y'all smash that like button, share the video as well. We are going to cover the boxes, the inside, the labels, everything, man. We're gonna run through this real quick. I ain't gonna hold you guys for a crazy long video. I tried to wrap it all up. It's a couple little differences, and in the end, I wanna in the comment section for you guys to interact with me and let me know what you guys feel about the actual price increase and for what they actually did. You know, is it worth the $30 hype? So let's start off with the boxes. Right here we have the 2014 box right here, and then we have the 2021 box right here. And you guys can see they look pretty much the same. The only thing that's different is the label. The little black labels look pretty much the same, maybe just a tad bit different font, colorway and everything the same. This one right here having a different tag. On the inside right here, you guys can see we have this tissue paper. We don't have the black trash bag tissue paper. I guess, you know, for the $30 increase from them originally being $170 back in 2014 to now being $200 retail is a difference. Now, right here on the bottom of the sneaker, you guys can see the bottoms look pretty much identical. Nothing really changing. If you ask me, I would say maybe the colorway is a tad bit different. But right here on the 2014 lace lock, you guys can see we have a Jumpman, and then there's nothing on the other side. On the 2021 pair, we have the Nike, and then we have the Jumpman on the other side of this one. So getting the Jumpman and the Nike, hey, I'm digging the vibes. Now, when it comes to that toe box, the toe box on the 2014 pair was stiff as a brick, if you ask me. And this pair right here, you see I'm barely touching it, and it's moving in. That's that 2021 pair having that nice soft. Now, right here, looking at the red, you guys can see, and I hope it's catching it on camera good in person, it has more of a shine to the 2021 pair, I feel like, than the 2014 pair. Now, when we look at the part right here, this is actually something that I thought it was going to change and be a little bit softer. On the 2014 pair, that part right there, it was a little hard, you know what I'm saying? Pause. But they thought, I thought that they were going to make it softer, but if you ask me, they're pretty much the same. Now, one thing that you guys can see as we were twirling it is that Nike Air branding. But right here, you guys can see when it comes to the Air unit pretty much the same. And there it is, the Nike Air on the back, and we had the Jumpman in the Air on the back of the 2014 pair. Of course, we haven't seen this since 1991. Now, different type of inserts and different stuff for the insert right here. As I said, for the inside, you see we had all this extra stuff, and here is the insert from 2014, and we have a newer model that we've been seeing in the 2021 pair. Now, when you're looking at the inside, you guys can see we have the Nike Air for the insole, still having the black, and we have the Jumpman right there on the 2014 pair. Definitely digging the vibes of having that classic OG type vibe with the Nike Air. Another thing that I noticed was right here, we have white going up the lacing area right here, and on this pair for the 2021 pair, you have black, and that goes all the way up. I'm gonna try to show you guys. I ain't trying to mess up the vintage pair right here, but we'll move up and I'll give you guys another look at it. Right here is probably a better look. You guys can see all that white, and then right here you have the black. I think that that's just like something small that they did to change out. And again, focusing in on this part right here, you can see that it looks a lot shinier, I feel like, on the 2021 pair. That's probably the only other thing that I'd note out. And maybe the color might be a smidget different. Just a smidget different. Not too crazy. All in all, I definitely think that the craftsmanship on the 2021 pair, we got some different things as far as having the Nike Air branding on the back of the sneaker, then having the Nike Air on the insole on the inside. As I said before, the colorway just feels like it's a smidget different. Just a smidget, dog. Like, it ain't too crazy, but I definitely can say right here on this part right here on the tongue, it does look a lot different. In my opinion, I feel like this one is a lot shinier and the Carmines are just a tad bit different. Do you feel like this was an upgrade? Do you feel like just because they added the Nike Air back there and then giving us the insole, switching out the tissue paper, giving us the different type of tissue paper that we've been seeing since they got rid of the trash bag recently? And I mean, just those small little things, do you think it's worth a $30 hike? I really think that they really could have just released this one at $190, but it is what it is. I'm still gonna go after the sneaker. Jordan brand, you got me again. They always give me. But you know, let me know down in the comment section below, how do you guys feel about the comparison seeing these? You feel like they did a great job? In my eyes, this being a remastered version from the version that we got in 2014, I honestly think that having the Nike Air and all that stuff is definitely a vibe, man, especially seeing that we haven't seen this sneaker look like this since 1991 when they originally released. I'm super excited to get my hands on a pair of these on February 13th. You guys already know when they drop, I will give you guys a full on feet of them. As of right now, I don't have them. I almost purchased them early, but I was like, man, I ain't trying to spend $350 to get them early. For $50 more plus tax, I can grab a double up. So I was like, man, I'll wait. But yes, this is your comparison of your 2014 Carmine Jordan 6s to your 2021 Carmine Jordan 6s. And for me, y'all already know which one I'm gonna rock out with. Both of the sneakers being pretty much the same, but having those small little differences as far as having the Nike Air branding, I gotta go with this one right here. This one now will officially come up out the box and be probably a rotation sneaker into the gym, because that's what I normally do. Once I get the upgraded version of it, I turn that one into pretty much just like an everyday. I might just throw it on and go to the gym. I might, you know, I'm gonna change up the laces and everything on these, and you know, I'm just gonna rock these a whole lot more. Make sure you guys comment down y'all's thoughts and opinions from the upgraded version, and as I would say, remastered version from the 2014 pair. Y'all already know, man, stay tuned to the channel. Tomorrow we're gonna be talking about a sneaker that I was really shocked that they did this, man. I ain't gonna lie. I knew it was gonna be something like this, but I didn't think they were gonna do it like this, man. So feelings kind of crushed in a way, but I think I'm gonna have to go into the bag, because I gotta have this one, man. I gotta have this sneaker that's gonna be coming out. So we'll be talking about that in tomorrow's video. Hope you guys continue to have a great evening. Peace, love in Laguna Beach, and we out this thing. Get it!
Jordan 1 retros, and they gotta be in your collection. You just collect them, you never gon' step in. I can respect it, but that ain't for me. I gotta lace up these black cement threes and throw a little fit together. Get on the go, L, place a bid, and hopefully I can just hit forever.